Time we would like to recognize one of our junior centers, Ishmael Lane, for reaching a career milestone. Last Wednesday in San Antonio, Ish hit a three-pointer to spark a game-closing 15-5 run that salted away a Demon victory. Not only did the basket ignite the Demons, it also made him the 31st player in more than a century of NSU basketball to score 1,000 points in his career. Coach McConathy and Miss Connie McConathy are presenting him with an inscribed ball commemorating this landmark. Congratulations to number 20 from Port Allen, Ishmael Lane. You can walk straight through hell with a smile. You could be the hero, you get the gold. Breaking all the records they thought never could be broke. Yeah, do it for your people, do it for your pride. You're never gonna know if you never even try. Do it for your country, do it for your And now, name. Ladies and gentlemen, we ask that you please rise for tonight's invocation. Offered by Andrew Fork, and remain standing to honor America with the playing of our national anthem by the best sounding band in the land, the Spirit of Northwestern Purple Haze Pep Band.
Let's pray. God, I thank you for this day. I thank you for this opportunity to watch both of these teams play. I ask that you let them be injury free, and I ask that everything we do in the stands and on the court honors and glorifies you. In your name I pray. Amen.
Welcome to Prather Coliseum on the beautiful campus of the Northwestern State University. And now let's get ready for tonight's game by meeting our starting lineups. First, for our visitors from Thibodeau. At guard, a 6'6 senior from Aberdeen, Maryland, number 1, Tavon Sadler. At guard, a 6-foot senior from Tallahassee, Florida, number 2, Javon Powell. At forward, a 6'10 freshman from Slidell, Louisiana, number 22, Raji Lyons. At guard, a 5'10 freshman from Thibodeau, Louisiana, number 25, Kevin Johnson. And at forward, a 6'7 senior from Flint, Michigan, number 35, Kamani Jackson. Head coach of the Colonels is Richie Riley, assisted by John Aiken, Austin Clouch, and Amaro Morgan. And now, fans, on your feet! And welcome tonight's Northwestern State starters! At guard, a 5'10 freshman from Monroe, Louisiana, number 0, C.J. Jones. At guard, a 6'7 junior from Clarence, Louisiana, number 10, Malik McGuire. At guard, a 6-foot freshman from El Dorado, Arkansas, number 15, Zon are Perry. At forward, a 6'8 junior from Port Allen, Louisiana. Number 20, Ishmael Lee. And at guard, a 5'11 senior from Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Number 44, Cameron Lazar. Head coach of the Demons is Mike McConaughey, assisted by Jeff Moore, Bill Lewitt, and Jacob Spielbauer.
5'10", 160. He's a freshman from Monroe out of Wasserman High School. Joined in the backcourt by Czar Perry, 6'170", the freshman from El Dorado, Arkansas, El Dorado High School. Malik Matwire, 6'7", 200, the junior from Clarence, Louisiana, Lakeview High School. Cameron Lazar, 5'11", 202, the senior from Baton Rouge, Louisiana, out of Woodlawn High School, the wide receiver, leading wide receiver for the Demon football team. And in the middle for the Demons, their most effective player all season long, Ishmael Lane, 6'8", 250, the junior from Port Allen High School, Port Allen, Louisiana. The Demons are coached by Mike McConaughey. He is 284 and 299 in his 19th year at the helm of the Demons. He is 635 and 458 overall in his 35th year as a head coach. So after Northwestern State turned it over 26 times at Nicholls, the Demons decided to play two point guards tonight. They'll start a pair of point guards. Kimani Jackson and Ishmael Lane will jump center, and that will be tipped back to Malik Matwire and into the hands of C.J. Jones. So Jones running the point. Czar Perry will be the off guard. Perry has it out deep, feeds it to Cameron Lazar, back to C.J. Jones, right wing. Malik Matwire feeds it down low to Lane. Lane back to the basket, steps through. Tough shot is up and good for Ishmael Lane. And the Demons do something with the first possession they did not do in Thibodeau. They get the lead. Demons never led in that game in Nicholls. So the Demons get the lead here. They lead 2-0. Ball at the top. Dribbling to the left side is the big fella, Rajay Lyons. He'll feed it down on the post. Kimani Jackson steps back. Long two, high arcing and no good back iron. Malik Matwire pulls down the rebound. Flips it to C.J. Jones to the left side. Crosses to the middle. Works to the right elbow. Stops. Pulls the high floater. Front iron no good. Rebound tipped out by Cameron Lazar, but picked up by the Colonels. Tavon Sadler has it stripped by Lazar, who can't quite get to it. He stripped it away and then fell down as he was diving to try to save it in bounds. 57 seconds gone by. The Demons lead 2-0, and again did not have the lead at any point down in Thibodeau. Speaking of down in Thibodeau, the Lady Demons are currently down 33-17 in that one. If you want to catch that one, it's on 100.7 FM KZBL. Rajay Lyons feeds it down on the block. We're going to have an offensive foul called on Kimani Jackson. Jackson picks up his first, and the Colonels are going to pressure full court here. Nicholls wearing the black-on-black road uniforms. The Demons are in the white unis. They'll flip it out to Ishmael Lane, to Czar Perry. Perry works all the way to the left wing, breaks the pressure easily to C.J. Jones just inside the half-court circle. Jones flips it to Cameron Lazar, out long to Czar Perry. Right wing C.J. Jones, lob inside the lane, turns to face on the right baseline, steps back, nowhere to go, lobs it back out to Matwire. Matwire out to Perry with 8 to shoot. Perry works off the high screen and roll, dribbles away from the double team, tries to throw it out. It's turned over into the hands of Kevin Johnson. Johnson back out, drive down the right side, stripped and out of bounds off of the Demons. Off of Malik Matwire as they look for Kimani Jackson. So the Demons turn it over for the first time. And they're going to put 26 on the shot clock. As the Demons lead 2-0, we're a minute and 38 seconds into the first half of play. Demons were blitzed down in Thibodeau. That was the first game without Jalen West, and it showed. C.J. Jones was really the only point guard available for the Demons in that ball game, and the Demons turned it over 26 times in that one. They turned it over once here. Nicholls will inbound. They throw it out long into the hands of Javon Powell. Powell looking for the high screen and roll. To the right wing, drive from there, flips it over to the left baseline, and that's an easy slam for Kimani Jackson. Makes it 2-2, as Jones will break the pressure by himself, draws a double team, flips it to Matwire. Matwire to Ishmael Lane into the right corner, Czar Perry. Perry will pull it all the way back out and reset. Perry will drive with the left hand, works all the way down to the left baseline, gets past his man, puts it up, that's off the glass and a goaltend. So Czar Perry will get the bucket on the goaltend. It went off glass and then was hit again once it was off the glass. Ball is in the hands of Kevin Johnson. Demons lead 4-2. Ishmael Lane with the steal. Saves it to Jones. Back to Lane. Lane down the right side of the lane. Lays it up and good. Ishmael Lane's got four. And the Demons lead 6-2. 2.5 gone by in the first half of play. It's a much different Demon team than the one that the Colonels saw down in Thibodeau. They get it out top. That's Tavon Sadler. He'll drive, spin inside, strip, but right into the hands of the big fella. He'll turn. Rajay Lyons misses it. Rebound to Ishmael Lane. Flips to Czar Perry. Perry into a crowd of folks up the left side to Lane at the top. Feeds it right baseline to Lazar. Back out to Czar Perry. 20 to shoot. Perry will pull it back out, and he'll run the point. Lazar out long. Looking for C.J. Jones. Flip it to Perry right wing. Lob inside the lane and a double team. Lane back out to a cutting Malik Matuire. Matuire puts it up, no good. Just missed it left side. Rebound pulled down by Kevin Johnson. Johnson brings it to the front court, left side. Tavon Sadler will drive, floats it with the right hand, no good. Tip up is good by Rajay Lyons. 6-4, Demons quickly break the pressure. Czar Perry flips it to Ishmael Lane, and he is pushed out of bounds. Foul will be called on Kevin Johnson, his first. Into the ball game, Roddy Peters, the leading scorer for Nicholls, 6'4", 195, the senior transfer from Washington, D.C., out of Suitland High School, University of Maryland, and the University of South Florida. And Daniel Regis, 6'7", 235, the junior transfer from Grenada, Louisiana, out of Gillette College. Ball in the right corner, Malik Matuire on the inbound. Dribbling out long right wing, looking for the high screen and roll. Spacing's not good. He gives it back out long to Czar Perry, guarded by Peters. Perry past Peters. Back up top to Matuire. Works, dribble handoff, C.J. Jones. Jones to the top of the key, down the lane. Goes to the right baseline, back to Ishmael Lane, left elbow. He'll create space, now pull a tough jumper, no good. Rebound in the corner, Matuire has it, knocks it off of Nicholls, and it'll belong to the Demons with a fresh 30-second clock. And Richie Riley, the second-year head coach for the Colonels, 34-26. He is unhappy with the way his team started, and the Demons turn it quite right over, but then Javon Powell steps on the sideline. So they'll reset the shot clock again as the Demons turned it over, but Powell then turned it right back over, stepping on the sideline. Demons lead 6-4. We're 3 minutes and 51 seconds into the first half of play. C.J. Jones now to Czar Perry. Perry dribbles to the left wing. Sends Cameron Lazar through. Now dribbles to the right wing. C.J. Jones stops to the top. Demons with two guys on the elbows either way. Now they'll set up the offense. They get a dish mail lane. Top of the key. He'll fire a three. Front iron no good. Rebound pulled down by Roddy Peters. Peters picked up by Cameron Lazar as he crosses over. Works down the left side of the lane. Has it stripped by Lazar. Those quick hands of the former Demon wide receiver. Malik Matuire out long to Czar Perry. Perry setting up the offense, calling out the play. He dribbles to the left wing, gives to C.J. Jones at the top. Jones dribbles out long right wing. 15 to shoot. Demons lead 6-4. Now Cameron Lazar dribbles to the left wing. Demons will finally get the offense running here. They give it to Matuire. Matuire will dribble down the left side of the lane, and he is fouled on his way down the lane. Foul is called on Daniel Regis. That is his first. And we've got our under 16 media timeout. 15-16 left to go in the first half of play. Northwestern State leads Nicholls 6-4. We'll take a timeout. Come back with more after this on the Demon Sports Network.
Again, reference the video board. Text DEMONS to 40213. If you receive a message that you have won, come on down to the score table and find the game day staff member to claim the best seat in the house.
This Demon Sports Network broadcast is brought to you by the Walk-Ons Independence Bowl, Chevyland, Hebert Town and Country, and Manpower. Northwestern State leads 6-4. The Demons with the basketball after the foul was called. So the Demons, so far so good in the early going. No subs as of yet for NSU. They stick with the starting five. Demons are 3 of 7 from the field for 43%. NSU will lob it into Ishmael Lane in the left corner. Throws it out long to Czar Perry. Perry will bring it in to the half court circle. Work with the left hand, drives right to the left side, steps back, almost throws it away. Cameron Lazar, great catch, works to the right side, C.J. Jones. He dribbles, nowhere to go. Now he's going to pull a three from the right wing, buries it. Turnaround three for C.J. Jones right against the shot clock, and the Demons lead 9-4 here in the early going. 14:47 remaining. They work it back to the left wing. Javon Powell out long. Roddy Peters against Czar Perry. Peters drives. Tough up and under shot is good. Roddy Peters knocks that one down. Czar Perry quickly back into the front court. Long on the left wing. Crosses over. Works against Peters. Spins. Pulls it all the way back out. Now works to the right wing on the dribble. 19 to shoot. Looking. Works all the way to the left wing. Gives to Cameron Lazar. Lazar working against Tavon Sadler to the right wing. 10 to shoot. Out to C.J. Jones. 7 to shoot. Jones works off a couple of screens into traffic. Feeds it underneath to Ishmael Lane. Lane's shot is blocked underneath. And Nicholls comes away with it. They lob it out ahead to Peters. Peters goes up with it. Shot is no good, but the foul is called on Malik Matuire. So Matuire will pick up his first personal. First time the Demons have really gotten beaten down the floor in this one. By the way, update from Ruston. The Demon baseball team is leading 1-0 in the third inning against Louisiana Tech. The Demon softball team split a pair with Prairie View A&M today. Won handily in the first one, 8-1, and then lost the second one, 4-2. But the Demons so far so good. A 1-0 lead in the top of the third against former skipper Lane Burrows and Louisiana Tech. Demons will bring four fresh bodies in. DeAndre Love, 6'4", 190, the junior transfer from Seattle, Washington, West Seattle High School, and Eastern Arizona Junior College. Darian Dixon, 6'8", 220, the freshman from Bowie, Maryland, out of Bishop McNamara, out of Scotland Performance Institute of Pennsylvania. Brandon Hutton, 6'5", 215, sophomore transfer from Chicago, Illinois, out of De La Salle High School, University of Iowa, and Indian Hills Community College, as both free throws are no good. And Larry Owens, also 6'8", 260, the freshman from Monroe out of Carroll High School. C.J. Jones stays in to run the point with this group. Jones dribbling off the high screen, works to the right baseline, stops, flips it back out. Hutton, three on the way from the right wing, front iron no good, rebound to the Colonels. Javon Powell looks to run. He'll flip it back to Lafayette Rutledge, who will immediately pull a three, no good. Offensive rebound inside, put back good, and the foul for Tavon Sadler. The bucket counts, and the foul is on DeAndre Love, his first. That makes it 9-8 in favor of the Demons. Tavon Sadler with his first points. Lafayette Rutledge, three-point specialist, 6'1", 175, the senior from Goshen, Mississippi, out of Goshen High School and Southwest Mississippi Community College. Rutledge is the guy you've got to watch out for from beyond the arc. Free throw is no good. Colonels, not a bad free throw shooting team. They're third best in the Southland, and they're 0 for the line so far in this one. Darian Dixon to Brandon Hutton, left wing. Hutton out long to C.J. Jones. 16 to shoot. Jones off the high screen from Owens, drives in, pulls up, no, flips it inside to Owens. Owens high with the left hand, good. Demons lead 11-8. NSU has not trailed so far in this first half. Ball out long as it's bobbled by Sadler, and then he throws it away looking for Roddy Peters. That is now 5 turnovers in the first half for the Colonels, who average 15 turnovers a game. Daniel Regis will check out. Back into the ballgame is Kimani Jackson. Into the front court, C.J. Jones looking for the high screen from Darian Dixon. Darian Dixon slips it. Jones dribbles to the left elbow, now gives to Hutton. Hutton pulls it back out, back to Jones in the left corner. He'll fire a three, bucket! C.J. Jones has a pair of threes, and Richie Riley is incensed. He calls a quick timeout. Demons lead by 6, 14-8. We'll take a 30-second break, 30 seconds, and back with more after this. You're listening to the Demon Sports Network. 6:49 left to go in the first half of play. The Demons lead 14-8. C.J. Jones had been a 29% three-point shooter coming in, 11 of 37 in conference play. He has knocked down a pair so far in this first half, and he has 6 points to lead the way for the Demons. Ball out long, Roddy Peters guarded by Brandon Hutton. Hutton, great athlete. Peters works with the left hand, takes it in, shot is up and good, and the foul on Brandon Hutton. According to Brent Moe, Hutton will pick up his first. Peters now with 4 points. He's the leading scorer for Nicholls, coming in averaging just over 19 a game. That's the second most in the league, behind, of course, Jordan Howard at Central Arkansas. Peters completes the three-point play, 14-11. The lead for the Demons, 12:25 left to go, first half of play. Into the front court, C.J. Jones. They run a trap at him. He's back around half court, steps through, and it's going to be a jump ball. Possession will go back to Nicholls. And Mike McConathy telling Darian Dixon, you've got to get out of there so that the double can't come. And so Northwestern State turns it over for the, I believe, fourth time in this ball game. Meanwhile, Nicholls has turned it over 5 times. And we're going to have a foul on Jones, out long on Javon Powell. C.J. Jones picks up his first personal. So Nicholls will inbound with 12:11 left to go in the first half of play. The Demons lead 14-11. Much more composed Demon team than the first game of the Southland Conference season, when NSU had just lost Jalen West and was sort of lost by everything. Peters gets it out long. Brandon Hutton will back off of him. Peters works with the right hand. Fumbled exchange to Javon Powell. Powell crosses over, works against Jones, takes it in, skips it across the lane. Shot is up, no good. Rebound put back is no good again and blocked. That's going to be a jump ball. Possession will go back to the Demons. 2 blocked shots on the same possession for NSU. Demons average just under 4.5 block shots per ball game. That's fourth best in the Southland Conference. They are good at that. And got a couple of blocks on that possession right there. We'll take a break. 14-11, NSU with the lead. Full break. Come back with more after this. You're listening to the Demons Sports Network.
Muchwire, congratulations, Miss Bailey.
Network broadcast is brought to you by Mike and Kenny Knotts, Salter Bus Lines, and Kilpatrick Life. Well, not good news from down in Thibodaux. The Lady Demons have been doubled up at halftime. Nicholls leads Northwestern State 44-22 at the half. Lady Demons are led by Libba Gillum with 7 points. Nicholls already has 3 different players in double digits in that one. Williams, Charles, and Barrios all in double digits. So, meanwhile, the Demon baseball team continues to lead at Louisiana Tech, 1-0 in the bottom of the third. And NSU leads here, 14-11. Brandon Hutton will drive down the left side, flip it back to the top of the key, drive down there from Darian Dixon. Bucket, but no, they're going to wave it off and call the charge on Darian Dixon. Dixon will pick up his first personal. Our officiating crew for this one, Brent Moe, Henry Howard, and Daniel Brown.
Buzz one.
Demons lead 14-11 with 11:49 left to go. Dixon picks up his first personal. The Demons have been called for 5. And there'll be 4 fresh bodies checking in when we get the next dead ball. Drive down the right side. Peters shot is blocked. Late foul is called by Henry Howard. Mike McConaughey doesn't like that call. Foul will be called on Brandon Hutton. That is his 2nd personal. So Peters will shoot more free throws. Roddy Peters on the season. has attempted 175 free throws. That is second most in the Southland Conference. He makes the first. He's got 6 points. Richie Riley's squad built on transfers. 8 seniors on his team, so it is now or never for Nicholls in this season. And they're right now have the opportunity with a win here. They would clinch at least a share of the Southland Conference Championship, which would guarantee the NIT berth if they do not make their way into the NCAA tournament. Foul is going to be called on Peters. That is his first as C.J. Jones is bringing into the front court. And Peters was riding him out on the sideline. So the Demons will inbound. C.J. Jones, Czar Perry, Cameron Lazar, Malik Matwire, Ishmael Lane, the five on the floor for the Demons. They get it into Perry out deep. He'll run the point here. C.J. Jones has played the entire first half so far. He gets the ball on the right wing. He's also hit a couple of threes. Jones to Malik Matwire at the top. Lob inside to Ishmael Lane. Tough catch. Gathers himself. Brings it down. Loses it. Lazar flips it back out to Matwire. Three from the top. Back iron no good. Rebound pulled down by Nicholls. Kevin Johnson brings it into the front court. Feeds to Roddy Peters. He'll drive left baseline, and he's fouled. And that'll be one-and-one free throws for Roddy Peters. Foul called on Malik Matwire, and that is his second. So Matwire and Brandon Hutton both with a pair of fouls. Demons have been tagged for 7 fouls. The Colonels just 4. Free throw disparity, 7-0 in favor of Nicholls so far. Demons have attempted no free throws. The Colonels have attempted 7, and it's about to be 8. Roddy Peters has 8. We're tied at 14. The Colonels have scored the last 6 in a row as Larry Owens will check in to replace Malik Matwire. So the Demons have both of their posts and both of their point guards on the floor, along with a wide receiver from the football team. Peters makes both. He's got 9. And Nicholls has its first lead of the ball game, 15-14, and we're going to have a foul called on Kevin Johnson. That's his second. Nicholls was pressing full court. That'll be the 5th team foul called against the Colonels. As Lafayette Rutledge didn't even check in. He just ran on the floor. He's got to check in. Lafayette Rutledge just ran out on the floor.
I just took a different guy out.
Well, he never went to check into the scores table, just ran onto the floor. So Lafayette Rutledge checks in, and we're good to go. Ishmael Lane will trigger the inbound. Going to get it to Czar Perry. Perry with a full head of steam goes behind the back, works all the way out to the right side, feeds it back to C.J. Jones to run the point. Demons trail by a point. Nicholls has scored the last 7 in a row. Perry left wing, guarded by Peters. Now flips it to the left elbow, turn and fire. That one rattles in and out, no good for Ishmael Lane. Rebound to Nicholls. Colonels want to run into the front court. It is Tavon Sadler guarded closely by Cameron Lazar. Screen and roll. Lazar works away from it. Now Sadler lobs it out to the right side to Peters, guarded by Czar Perry. 13 to shoot. Screen and roll coming. Peters works away from it. Goes up. That's going to be no good. There's the charging foul called on Roddy Peters. That's his second. C.J. Jones stepped right in front of him and drew the charge. So they wipe out the basket for Peters. He'll pick up his second personal, and Peters, who has 9 points and no one else has more than 2 for Nicholls, has to leave the game. 10:24 left to go. It's a big moment in this first half of play. Demons trail by a point, and the leading scorer is gone. Ishmael Lane gets the high pass ahead. Cameron Lazar, he'll drive in. Takes it all the way up. Lazar, gone! There it is! Cameron Lazar's first points of the year. Gives the Demons back the lead, 16-15, with 10 minutes left to go in the first half of play. And then he strips the ball from Tavon Sadler, but they get him with the foul. Foul was called on Cameron Lazar, his first, but Lazar finally got his first points of the year on a beautiful drive and layup. And Cameron Lazar, who has started now the last 4 games in a row, gets his first points as a Demon. Love it. We actually had a little bit of a fun wager going. Who would get their first points, Cam or Kim? Cameron Lazar or Stephen Kim? And Stephen Kim has not yet played, the Demon athletic trainer. But Cam Lazar finally gets on the scoring table. And I told Cameron Lazar before the game, if you let the trainer score before you, we'll probably pull your scholarship, even though he's not a basketball scholarship player. By the way, both free throws missed for Tavon Sadler, and the Demons lead 16-15 after Lazar's drive and layup. Lazar Perry into the front court. Demons lead by a point. Top of the key, Larry Owens, right elbow. He'll drive the right baseline, goes up in traffic and puts it up and in. Big fella doing work. Demons retake the lead 18-15 with 9:40 left to go in the first half of play. Javon Powell into the front court. Gives it out long right side to Tavon Sadler. Top of the key, the big man, Rajay Lyons. Gets it on the give and go. Now feeds it across the lane. Shot is up and good. Kind of a half dunk for Kimani Jackson. 18-17, Demons with the lead. Czar Perry skips it all the way across to Cameron Lazar. Lazar, left baseline, Larry Owens. Owens, crossover dribble, works to the baseline, reverses, good. Oh, the nimble feet and quick moves of Larry Owens. Puts it up and in with the reverse, and the Demons lead 20-17 with 9 minutes left to go. Demons are shooting 53% from the field right now. In the first matchup, they shot 27%. All out long left wing, Lafayette Rutledge. Got to watch him from three. Out long to Javon Powell at the top. Seven to shoot against Cameron Lazar. High screen and roll. Down the lane. Backside lob and an easy dunk for Kimani Jackson. 20-19. Someone fell asleep on the backside. C.J. Jones dribbles between defenders and will bring it into the front court himself. Demons lead 20-19. 8.5 left to go. First half of play. Jones out deep. Dribbling now into the right baseline for Ishmael Lane. He drives past his defenders, and he's fouled as he goes up with it. And Ishmael Lane will shoot free throws. Foul called on Rajay Lyons. And so Rajay Lyons, the freshman, picks up his first personal, and Ishmael Lane will go to the line to shoot two. 8:20 left to go in the first half of play, and the Demons lead 20-19. First free throw for Lane is perfect. Ishmael Lane, 5 points in the first half. The bigs are doing work in this one. Lane has five. Larry Owens has six. In the first matchup, Owens had 3 points, and Ishmael Lane had a double-double with 11 points and 10 rebounds. The junior from Port Allen, 9 double-doubles on the season so far this year. He hits both. He's got 6 points. Demons lead 22-19, 8:18 left to go. In the first half of play, Demons playing much more comfortably in this one than they did in that first matchup. Drive down the right side by Sadler. Shot is blocked by Darian Dixon. Gives the rebound to C.J. Jones. Ahead to Czar Perry. Perry with no numbers. Puts it to a cutting Ishmael Lane. Spins, dribbles, puts it up and in. Lane's got eight, and the Demons lead by five, 24-19. 7:53 left to go, first half of play. Demons playing very well defensively. A lot of blocked shots. And offensively as well. Demons are shooting 56% from the field. The difference is they haven't turned it over. Only 4 turnovers in the first half. High screen and roll, and that's going to be an offensive foul on the illegal screen called on Kimani Jackson, and that is his second. And we'll have our under 8 media timeout. 7:37 left to go in the first half of play. Northwestern State leading 24-19. We'll take a break, come back with more after this. You're listening to the Demons Sports Network.
And Coach Pickett, the winningest coach in program history, will be throwing out the first pitch. Game time is 5 p.m. this Friday. We will see you there.
State Farm agents Buddy Wood, Jim Pledger, Glenn Talbert, Mike Murphy, and Linda Luck. Northwestern State leading 24-19 with 7:37 left to go in the first half of play. Demons playing very well here in the early going, shooting 55% from the field. Nicholls shooting 54%. Jones out long, has been in the ball game the entire time. C.J. Jones dribbles around, has now Darian Dixon, DeAndre Love, Larry Owens, and Brandon Hutton on the floor with him. Jones out long to Hutton at the top, dribbles to the right wing, crosses over, works down the lane with it, flips it back to Owens. Owens stripped, then back to Dixon, who lays it up and in. Darian Dixon's first points of the ball game gives the Demons a 7-point lead, 26-19. The Demons have scored six in a row. Ball out long, that's lost by Nicholls, but picked up by Tavon Sadler. Sadler against Dixon will drive with the right hand, shot is blocked, gets it back, puts it up and in. Sadler's got four, makes it 26-21 in favor of the Demons with 6:43 left to go in the first half of play. C.J. Jones sort of chuckling and laughing to himself as he brings it up the floor. Brandon Hutton down the left side, takes it up with the reverse, no good. Rebound pulled down by the Colonels. Javon Powell over to Roddy Peters. Into the right corner it goes. Rutledge fires a three short, rattles around. Rebound DeAndre Love, he was the only one under the basket. Lobs it ahead to C.J. Jones with 6:19 left to go. He'll walk it into the front court. Demons leading by five, 26-21. Hutton has it at the top. Works it off to the left wing. Picks up his dribble. Now looking for somewhere to go. Throws it to DeAndre Love in the left corner. Love will drive left baseline, and that's a foul. And that'll be free throws for DeAndre Love. Foul on Lafayette Rutledge will be the senior's first personal. And DeAndre Love will shoot 1-1 here. DeAndre Love has only made two trips to the free throw line in his entire Demon career. Keep in mind, he only got healthy 9 games ago. This is his 10th game to play as he knocks in the first free throw. He did not play in the first matchup at Nicholls. He was still battling that foot injury. Has played the last 9 games, averaging just under 2.5 points and 2 rebounds a game. Second free throw, both of those are good. Love with his first 2 points of the ball game makes it 28-21. Demons with the lead, 6 minutes left to go, first half of play. Into the front court, Roddy Peters guarded by Brandon Hutton. Peters backs it out. Now we'll work with the left hand, crosses over to the right, works down the right side of the lane. Shot up is good. Roddy Peters has 11. He's playing with 2 fouls because the Colonels need him, especially offensively. He's been all the offense for the Colonels in the first half. He's got 11 of his team's 23 points. Into the front court, C.J. Jones. Brandon Hutton at the top. Hutton works all the way to the left wing. Feeds to DeAndre Love. Love dribbles to the right wing. Looking. Now back to Hutton on the left side. 10 to shoot. Hutton. Step back right. Elbow jumper is no good. He thought he was fouled. No call. Flip ahead to Roddy Peters. Peters will take it up, and he'll lay it up and in. Brandon Hutton just got away from him, and Peters fell down. 28-25. Peters complaining to Daniel Brown, our third official, as is his head coach, Richie Riley. Jones into the front court, bumped hard, no call. Hutton at the top now. Hutton, who thought he was fouled on that last jump shot attempt, holds on to it, flips it out to Darian Dixon. Dixon back to C.J. Jones. 10 to shoot. Jones works with the left hand, takes it up with the left side. It's no good, but he's fouled, and that'll be free throws. Foul will be called on Javon Powell. That is his first. And C.J. Jones will go to the line to shoot a pair. Now, Jones was being fouled all the way down the side of the lane. He was being ridden on the body.
Don't talk to anybody. They're coming the second time.
First free throw for C.J. Jones is no good. Richie Riley screaming at Javon Powell not to talk to the officials. Demons will bring in 3 fresh bodies. Cameron Lazar, Czar Perry, and Ishmael Lane with Larry Owens and C.J. Jones. Jones, the freshman point guard, has played the entire first half. Second free throw for Jones is good. He makes 1 of 2. He's got 7 to lead the way for the Demons. 29-25, NSU with the lead. 4:40 left to go in the first half of play. Peters working against Lazar, drives in. Shot is short. Rebound, tip back to Peters. Puts it back up, and he's fouled. And Brent Moe tells Richie Riley to calm down. Foul called on Larry Owens is his first. And so Roddy Peters goes back to the free throw line to shoot more. Peters will be attempting free throws number 8 and 9. First one is no good. He's now 5 for 8 from the free throw line. He already has 15 points in this ballgame. Second free throw is also no good. Ishmael Lane clears the rebound. Clips it ahead to C.J. Jones. Jones waits, now walks it into the front court. Demons by 4 with 4:25 left to go. First half of play. Cameron Lazar out long, right wing, feeds to C.J. Jones. Jones spins to the right corner. Now back out, trying to get it inside to Owens, and does. Owens turns to face, back to the basket, spins baseline, up with it off glass, too strong. Rebound pulled down by Nicholls. They'll look to run. Up the left side, Peters. He'll drive in from there, around to the right side, and that's going to be an easy lay-in for Tavon Sadler. Sadler's got 6, makes it 29-27. NSU with the lead. 3:53 left to go in the first half of play. Lazar Perry into the front court, turns it over, trying to throw it to the left side, back the other way. Shot is up and good for Javon Powell, his first points of the ball game, and we're tied at 29. And Mike McConaughey wants a timeout. That's just a careless turnover by the Demons, something they really haven't done much of in this first half. Got to be better with the basketball. 3:39 left to go, first half of play. We're tied at 29. We'll take a full break, come back with more after this. You're listening to the Demons Sports Network.
Join the Demons Unlimited Foundation and support more than 375 Division I student-athletes. Benefits include VIP football and courtside basketball seating, as well as priority parking. Call 318-357-5251 or visit nsudemons.com/unlimited to make your donation today.
Is brought to you by State Farm agents Tommy Chester, Trey Murray, Mickey Walker, and Julie Henderson. Demons and Colonels tied at 29. Colonels trying to win the Southland Conference, or at least a share of the Southland Conference championship with a win tonight. The trophy is actually in the building tonight. If the Colonels do win, they will have a trophy ceremony, but in the locker room. They won't do it on the floor. And the Demons are trying to play spoiler here, and so far playing well, 50% from the field. However, Nicholls is shooting 60% from the field. They are 12 of 20. Demons being out-rebounded 13-10, and NSU has just 5 turnovers. Points off turnovers, 12-6 in favor of the Colonels. That's much better for the Demons. Ishmael Lane into the front court, breaking the pressure, gives it back to C.J. Jones. Jones right side to Cameron Lazar. They cross screen for Larry Owens, pull it back to Ishmael Lane at the top. He's being left alone. He could shoot that if he wanted to. Jones to Zar Perry. Lob inside to Owens. Owens has it knocked away with 7 to shoot. Could have very easily been a foul on Tavon Sadler as he bodied up Larry Owens. 7 to shoot as the Demons will line up 3 across in front of the rim. That's their favorite set as Jones will trigger the inbound. Double cross screen. They lob it to Lane with 5 to shoot. Sar Perry, deep 3 from the right wing, high arcing, no good. Long rebound to Larry Owens. Owens puts it back up, no good. Rebound finally will be an over-the-back violation called on Cameron Lazar. Lazar will pick up his 2nd personal. And that'll be free throws on the other end. For Nicholls, the Colonels have doubled up the Demons in free throw attempts so far. The Demons are 5 of 6. The Colonels are 5 of 12. The good news is, the Colonels aren't outscoring the Demons from the stripe, even though they've had twice as many attempts. 29 apiece with 3:06 left to go in the first half of play. And to the free throw line goes Tavon Sadler, the senior transfer from UNC Greensboro. 8 seniors on this Nicholls roster. As Sadler makes the first, he's a transfer from UNC Greensboro. Roddy Peters, transfer from South Florida by way of Maryland. Kanani Jackson, transfer from Colorado State. Stevie Repikowski, transfer from Tulsa. Both free throws are good, and Nicholls actually has its largest lead of the first half. 31-29. Ishmael Lane breaks the pressure. He'll hand off to C.J. Jones in the half-court circle. 2:55 left. Demons down by two with the basketball. Czar Perry at the top turns to face against Lafayette Rutledge. Works to the left wing. Now dribbles it all the way back to the right wing. Works with the left hand. Takes it to the free throw line. Pulls that jumper. Front iron no good. Rebound comes back to Perry. Flips it inside the lane, and he's fouled by Roddy Peters, and that is his third. That is huge. Henry Howard talking or listening to Roddy Peters saying he had the ball, but Ishmael Lane had his hands on it. Peters grabbed the arms, and that's his third foul now of the first half. That is a huge development. Peters with 15 in the first half. No one else has more than six for the Colonels. So Ishmael Lane goes to the free throw line to shoot two here. First one is no good. Just over the front rim and pop back out. Peters will leave. Into the ball game is Reggie Lyons. And so Lane will go back to the line. Demons are 5 for 7 from the charity stripe in this one. Second free throw. That one's back iron, no good. And the rebound pulled down underneath by Daniel Regis. Into the front court, Tavon Sadler. Sadler spins at the left elbow, pulls it all the way back out. Cameron Lazar will follow him. Demons down by two, 31-29 with 2:24 remaining. They get it to Rutledge. Good look at a three left wing, and that's no good. Long rebound, though. Cameron Lazar goes flying down for it and sits it to C.J. Jones. Jones presses into the front court. Stops, pulls up from five, no good front iron, rebound pulled down by the Colonels. Good look from Jones, just couldn't get it to fall. Powell works to the left elbow, all the way back out, flips it underneath, drive from the left side, spin, fadeaway is high arcing and no good. Tip up is no good again, long rebound, and that'll go out of bounds, it'll belong to the Demons with a minute 56 remaining. Cameron Lazar selling out, not afraid to use that body. The leading receiver for the Demons this year, Cameron Lazar, 36 catches, 314 yards, 2 TDs, finished his career with 60 receptions for 652 yards and 3 TDs. And Lazar will come out replaced by DeAndre Love here for offensive purposes. Love has a pair, both at the free throw line. C.J. Jones has 7 to lead the way. Larry Owens has 6. Ishmael Lane has 8. For the Demons. Jones into the front court. Here comes the double team. Feeds to Lane. Top of the key for three. Good! Ishmael Lane's got 11. Demons retake the lead, 32-31. Good look from Jones to Lane on that one. Minute 35 left. NSU leads 32-31. Double screen at the top. Jones does a nice job with that. Push from the free throw line is no good. Larry Owens collects that rebound. Owens will dribble it out himself and flip it to Czar Perry along the right side. Perry pulls it into the front court. C.J. Jones already with 3 assists in the first half. Lane at the top. Flips it inside to Owens. Turns. Owens shot block. Gets his own rebound. Flips it back to Lane. Pump fakes back to Owens. Owens can't handle it. He picks it back up. And now we're going to have a stoppage of play as I believe we have an injury. As immediately popping up, Tavon Sadler. Brent Moe stopped play. I think he thought Sadler was seriously injured. And so now the Demons, who should have been able to press their advantage, and Brent Moe knows it, he's going to take Tavon Sadler out of the ballgame because he stopped play to get him out. Stevie Repikowski will check in, 6'5", 195, the redshirt senior from Lansing, Michigan, out of Catholic High School and the University of Tulsa, or Tulsa University. Lane, lob inside to Larry Owens, loses it on the way up, gets it back, puts it back up, it is no good. Tip up again and all the way out long, and Lafayette Rutledge has it. It's a 3-on-3. Left side, drive from there. Shot blocked by Ishmael Lane. Czar Perry comes flying ahead. Left side, Owens. Owens with the slam with the right hand. Oh, the big fella throwing it down. 34-31. The Demons with the lead with 35 seconds left to go in the first half of play. Best performance and a half so far for this Demon team, no doubt about it. Repikowski out deep. Lafayette Rutledge. Left wing, Javon Powell, 13 to shoot. High screen and roll. They slip it back underneath to Regis. Regis spins baseline into a double team, puts it up, shot blocked. Rebound C.J. Jones. Jones into the front court, works with the left hand, flips it back to DeAndre Love. Love shot blocked, foul called. Free throws for DeAndre Love with 11 seconds left to go. Foul called on Daniel Regis is his second. And DeAndre Love, that's some flashes of Demon basketball right there, by the way. This is a very, very young team. Fifth youngest team in the nation coming in. And two of those other four, by the way, Kentucky and Duke, as DeAndre Love misses the first free throw. Zar Perry will check out. Vontae Ott is in, 6'3", 185, the freshman from Victorville, California, Hesperia High School. Demons started 5 of 7. They've missed their last three free throws. Love's second one is good. DeAndre Love's got three. The Demons have a four-point lead now, 35-31. Seven to go here. Drive down the right side. Shot is up and no good, but a foul is called with 4 seconds left on DeAndre Love on the drive by Tavon Sadler. Love picks up his second. Sadler will shoot two. And then the Demons will, assuming this is Demon rebound or inbound, they will have 4.3 seconds to play with. Demons have scored the last six in a row after Nicholls had scored six. Demons have pushed their lead back to four. NSU is led by as much as seven. Nicholls by two. Free throw for Sadler is good. Tavon Sadler's got nine. 35-32 as DeAndre Love will check out. Zar Perry is in. Perry, who could certainly go the length of the floor in 4.3 seconds. See if Sadler knocks down both, and he does. So Sadler's got 10. They get it into Zar Perry. 35-33. Perry splits defenders just inside half court. No! Just missed it to the right side. That was a good look, though, but a great first half for the Northwestern State Demons. And Mike McConathy is going to call his squad back, as I believe they're going to have the senior day ceremony for Isaiah Sweeney here right before halftime.
Fans, at this time, we would like to recognize, in his second season with the Demons, number one, Isaiah Sweeney! After transferring from East Los Angeles College, Isaiah has played in 56 games, starting 42, averaging just under 10 points in his career. With Isaiah tonight are his mom, Lakita Sweeney, and his cousins, Jakar Martis, Joey Martis, and Zini Martis, and his girlfriend, Skylar Belmonte. Please welcome from Compton, California, number one, Isaiah Sweeney!
Greed, this is my kingdom come, this is my kingdom come.
We also have another special presentation to make. She is called Aunt D by most, but she is one of the most ardent supporters of NSU basketball. She was an outside voice of reason to the players, a shoulder to lean on during the hard times. She is the number one fan of NSU basketball and trusted friend of the program, Miss Donna Motter. Plaque is in honor of his top 10 finish in the most courageous award for Division I basketball. Trey McCrory has been around Demon basketball most of his life. As a kid, his dad brought him to the games, and when he was in college, he became the team manager and then a GA for the program. Trey has overcome a lot of physical obstacles due to his low vision, but he has always pushed through. Ladies and gentlemen, Trey McCrory. Demon fans, a big round round of applause once more for Miss Donna Monner and Mr. Trey McCrory.
Field, but knocked down a couple of free throws and ultimately held on to the lead at halftime. The Demons led by as much as 7 at 26-19. Nicholls led by as much as 2 at 31-29. Demons outscored the Colonel 6-2 down the stretch right before halftime. Nicholls allowed the basketball first. Javon Powell, Tavon Sadler, along with Kevin Johnson, Kimani Jackson, and Rajay Lyons. Stripped by Cameron Lazar, picked up by C.J. Jones. Jones is going to be tied up, and that'll go back to the Demons. Nice job once again, Cameron Lazar with another strip. Well, when you're a wide receiver and you're the leading wide receiver for the Demons, you tend to have fast hands, and you're not afraid to get dirty. Cameron Lazar has been on the floor multiple times in this one. And the Demons have the basketball. C.J. Jones to the right side, pulls it back out on the right wing, looking inside for Ishmael Lane. Now we'll give it to Malik Matuire. Bounce pass into Lane. That's going to be a foul as they reached around. Rajay Lyons reached around and fouled Ishmael Lane. So the Demons will inbound from the right baseline. 27 seconds. Demons will line up three across in front of the rim like they like to do in the lane. They'll just lob it to Ishmael Lane. Lane at the free throw line, back to Jones, pump fakes, drives from the right baseline, gets his defenders in the air, then has his shot blocked out of bounds. Jones pump fake, got three guys in the air, but was still a little too small to go up and try to either draw the foul or get that bucket to fall. Jones will trigger the inbound. They're going to lob it into Ishmael Lane in the right corner. He'll turn to face there with 10 to shoot. Lane goes back to the basket, has it stripped. Picked up by Kevin Johnson. Johnson into the front court. Works down the right side of the lane. Back to the right side. Back to Johnson. He'll work out deep against Czar Perry. Demons with C.J. Jones, Czar Perry, Cameron Lazar. Drive in from Tavon Sadler. Shot is no good. Rebound should have been over the back. Instead, it's a putback for Kimani Johnson. Mike McConaughey yelling for an over-the-back foul. Full court pressure by Nicholls. Czar Perry will get the ball from Cameron Lazar and bring it in. C.J. Jones has it. Gives to Lazar long at the top. Lazar beats Czar Perry. Right side to C.J. Jones. Jones lob inside to Matuire. Matuire pushed. No call. Then lobs it to Ishmael Lane. Ball is picked up under the basket by Nicholls. Sadler looks to run out with it. He fires it up the right side. Johnson. Johnson flips it and throws it out of bounds. Was looking inside for Kimani Jackson, who was right in front of the rim. And so the Demons will see the Colonels give them back the basketball. Little man pressure in the backcourt. Jones will get the inbound from Matuire. And here comes the double team. Jones dribbling away from it, around it, and brings it into the front court. Jones flips it left baseline. Czar Perry drives from there, skips it to the right corner. Back up top the lane, Matuire left alone for three. Good! Malik Matuire's first points of the ball game. Demons lead 38-35. Nice look. Ishmael Lane picks up his second assist of the ball game. Ball out long, left side. Kimani Jackson, the big man, out to Kevin Johnson around right wing. Now back up top the Lions, hand off to Powell. Back left wing, Jackson looking inside, can't get it inside. And now we're going to have an offensive foul called on Kimani Jackson. Knocked out C.J. Jones on the illegal screen. That'll be his third. So back the other way we go. Demons lead 38-35. C.J. Jones will walk it into the front court. Javon Powell on him. Works with the left hand all the way to the left wing. Steps back, gives to Czar Perry. Long at the top, dribbles with the right hand. Back to the basket now. Perry goes all the way around to the left wing. Double team comes out there. Perry dribbles away from it, flips it to Lane. He'll pull a three from there. Front iron no good. Malik Matuire flies in, can't hit the putback. on the reverse, and it comes down to the Colonels. Javon Powell crosses over, stops, takes the three from the top, buries it. Javon Powell's got five. We're tied at 38. Czar Perry will work off a screen. Now flip it back to Matoire. Matoire will not press the advantage he had. He'll give it back to Perry. 19 to shoot, 17 minutes left to go. Demons and Colonels tied at 38. Cameron Lazar at the top, works all the way to the left wing, drives the left baseline, pulls it all the way back out to the left wing. All the way to the top, all the way around to the right wing. Double team comes there. Lazar bumped out of bounds, but instead goes off of Lazar and out of bounds. Boy, Kimani Jackson bumped Lazar pretty hard as he was moving around to the baseline. Looked like it got Kimani Jackson in a sensitive area right below the waist. So Nicholls with the basketball, tied at 38. Drive on the right side by Tavon Sadler. A little push off, and the floater is good for Sadler. He's got 10, and the Colonels lead 40-38. Czar Perry back the other way. He splits defenders, turns it over. Nicholls comes away with it. A little too much dribbling for Perry. Back the other way, Sadler skips it left corner. Three on the way from there. That one's no good. Offensive rebound. Putback is blocked by Ishmael Lane. And then the rebound by Cameron Lazar. Lazar flips it to C.J. Jones, and Jones will bring it into the front court. Ishmael Lane picks up his third block of the ball game. Comes in, Lane averaging just under two blocks a game, second best in the Southland. Ishmael Lane turns, drives down the right side, has it stripped from behind into the front court. Javon Powell takes it all the way. Layup is up and good for Javon Powell. Colonels have their biggest lead of the ball game, 42-38. Demons turning it over in the front court here. They had five turnovers in the first half. They already have five here in the second half. C.J. Jones out long, 15 and a half left to go. Demons down four. Jones works to the top, works down the left side, turns around. Ishmael Lane at the top, feeds it mid-post, Malik Matoire. Matoire spins baseline, floats it with the left hand, good. Malik Matoire's got five. That's a big bucket for the Demons. Makes it 42-40 in favor of the Colonels. You definitely don't want to let Nicholls get too far in front of you.
Hey, over here, pistol.
Javon Powell will pull it back out. 15:07 left to go, and the Demons down two. Powell off the screen and roll. Works left baseline. Shot is blocked by Malik Matoire. Picked up by Lazar to Czar Perry. Perry flies into the front court with it. He'll take it right down the lane. Lefty scoop is good. Czar Perry ties us back up. Czar Perry's got four, and we're tied at 42 with 14:48 left to go. Great response by the Demons. Got down four, scored 4 points in a row. Into the front court, Tavon Sadler. He'll drive in, spin, and that's a traveling violation. We'll go the other way. Cameron Lazar pulled the chair out from under Tavon Sadler, and we've got our under 16 media timeout. It comes with 14:38 left to go, and we are tied at 42. We'll take a break, come back with more after this. You're listening to the Demons Sports Network.
We are building the time.
This Demon Sports Network broadcast is brought to you by the Walk-Ons Independence Bowl, Chevyland, Hebert Town and Country, and Manpower. Northwestern State tied up with Nicholls at 42 apiece. The Demons doing a nice job of controlling their turnovers. They have 10 for the game, but they have already five in the second half. They had just five at halftime. But they're also forcing turnovers, 11 turnovers now by the Colonels. And the Demons have 10 assists in this game. Coming in, the Demons were second to last, averaging just under 10 assists a ball game. Now they find themselves with 10 here. Demons will break the pressure. Larry Owens will dribble it to Darian Dixon, and Dixon will hand it off to C.J. Jones. 20 to shoot, Demons and Colonels tied at 42 with 14:25 remaining. Brandon Hutton on the left wing. Right wing, DeAndre Love. Back to C.J. Jones. Lob inside to Larry Owens. Owens goes up with the reverse. He's fouled, not called, misses it. Rebound pulled down by the Colonels. Boy, that was a clear foul on the arm of Larry Owens, not called. Javon Powell to Tavon Sadler. He'll drive the right side. Shot is up off glass, no good. Rebound tipped out long, controlled by the Colonels. Kimani Jackson will throw it all the way back out to Javon Powell. High screen and roll. Now back the other way. Demons switch that either way. They flip it inside to Jackson. Jackson spins baseline, puts it up and good. Actually, that was Reggie Lyons who put that one up. 44-42, Colonels with the lead. Lyons off the assist from Jackson. DeAndre Love, long left wing. Love skips to Brandon Hutton, right wing. Hutton dribbles with the right hand. Pulls it back. Right corner, C.J. Jones. He'll drive right baseline. Trap throws it off of the Colonels out of bounds. Kick ball. So they'll put 15 back on the shot clock with 13:24 left to go. Demons down 44-42. So they're actually going to put 20 on the shot clock. Demons will line up three across in front of the rim, which is what they like to do.
Go with him.
C.J. Jones gets it into the corner to Brandon Hutton. Hutton dribbles it out a little bit, and he's going to get called for the offensive foul. Pushed off with the offhand, and Brandon Hutton picks up his third personal. 13:20 left. Demons have played very well in this one, now shooting 42% from the field. Nicholls is shooting 49%. And the Demons, that is their 11th turnover of the ball game. Had 26 in the first matchup. They try to go down underneath, and Darian Dixon, ball looks like it was thrown to him, and then he can't quite convert it to C.J. Jones. Mike McConathy telling Darian Dixon, hold on to it. He was falling out of bounds. He thought he was fouled. And as he was falling out of bounds, he tried to slip it to Jones, but it was a little wide and out of bounds. So the Colonels will have a fresh 30-second clock. Demons do a nice job as Ishmael Lane gets set to check back into the ballgame. Ball at the top for Lyons, left wing Javon Powell. Up top to Tavon Sadler. He'll fire a three, no good. Left side rebound, Larry Owens collects it. Larry Owens with his fifth rebound of the ballgame. That's a team high. C.J. Jones into the front court. Demons down two with the basketball. C.J. Jones out long dribbling. Looking for the high screen from Darian Dixon. There comes the double team. Jones works all the way around the double team. Flips it inside to Dixon, who loses it. Ball is on the floor. Finally will be picked up and Ruckum Sock'em Robots underneath, and the Colonels will get the ball back. But wasn't a bad idea on the Jones pass to Darian Dixon. He just wasn't quite ready for it. He couldn't hang on to it. So Mike McConathy is going to take the towel and go wipe up the floor himself. A very Mike McConathy move as Ishmael Lane checks in for Larry Owens. Owens has had a heck of a ball game. The freshman, 8 points, 5 rebounds in this one. Ishmael Lane has had 11 and 2, so between them, 19 points and 7 rebounds. And that's a junior and a freshman together. You look on the floor right now for the Demons, they have one guy who played last year for NSU, and that's Ishmael Lane. Larry Owens actually stayed in. I thought he was checking out. He stayed in. So Ishmael Lane, Larry Owens, Brandon Hutton, DeAndre Love, and C.J. Jones with 12:28 left to go. And Brent Moe tells Mike McConathy to stay in the box while he was out there drying off the floor. A little tongue-in-cheek there. Peters working against Hutton, drives down the right side. Shot blocked by Ishmael Lane into the hands of Lane. Beautiful job on help side defense. Lane picks up his fourth block of the ball game. C.J. Jones into the front court, 12:09 remaining, and the Demons are down two. They get it to Ishmael Lane at the top. Skips it right wing to DeAndre Love into the corner for Brandon Hutton. Hutton throws it back out to Owens at the top. Owens wants someone to come get it. Only 5 to shoot. He steps back, flips it right wing Hutton. He's going to have to fire one. It's actually going to be a foul, and that should be 3 free throws for Brandon Hutton. Got him on the arm, did Javon Powell. His second, and Brandon Hutton will go to the line to shoot 3. Now we've got our under 12 media timeout. 11:47 left to go. Northwestern State down two, but there will be three free throws for Brandon Hutton when we return. You are listening to the Demon Sports Network. Kenny Knotts, Salter Bus Lines, and Kilpatrick Life. Well, last time we checked down in Thibodeau, it was not good news for the Lady Demons, and it remains not good news. 85-53, the lead for Lamar. 85-53, they are handling the Lady Demons down in Thibodeau. That ball game late. So Brandon Hutton will go to the line to shoot three after he was fouled shooting a three with 2 seconds left on the shot clock. He makes the first free throw. That is the first point of the ball game for Brandon Hutton. Makes it 44-43 Nicholls. Hutton misses the second free throw. One more he will get and hopefully knock it down to tie the ball game. Hutton, not a very long free throw regimen there, just a dribble and hoists it up. He makes two of three and ties us back up at 44 apiece. 11:40 remaining. Roddy Peters, leading scorer either way. He gets it back on the right wing, gets off a screen, now feeds it right side to Javon Powell. Out to Peters, left wing. Reggie Lyons, nowhere to go with it, with 11 to shoot. Back cut up the left side to Peters, and that's going to be a foul called on Brandon Hutton. And two free throws. As Hutton picks up his fourth, Peters on the back cut. So Brandon Hutton, who knocked down two of three free throws to tie us back up, then commits the foul. He was kind of in between trying to take a charge and trying to body up defensively, and he kind of got caught in no man's land. Roddy Peters, though, misses the first free throw. Colonels have hit just 9 of 17 from the free throw line for 53%. Demons have hit 61%. Peters' second free throw is good. He's got 16. That's his first point of the second half, though. 45-44. Nicholls with the lead. C.J. Jones into the front court. Looking for the screen and roll with Ishmael Lane. He slips it to the right corner. He's going to fire the three short. Deep rebound pulled down by the Colonels. They'll lob it ahead. It's suddenly a three-on-one all the way to the left corner. Powell, he'll fire the three. That one's good. Javon Powell's got 10-8 in the second half, and the Colonels lead by four, 48-44, with 10:58 remaining. Into the front court, C.J. Jones, off a screen from Ishmael Lane. Demons have been down four twice now. Jones works to the left wing, picks up his dribble, looking for somewhere to go. Now it's tipped. He gets it to Lane, back to Jones. Jones penetrates, back to Lane. Left wing, step back three, front iron no good. Tip up is no good by Love. Tip up again is good, DeAndre Love. He's got five. Demons have cut the lead to two, 48-46. Big, big putback there by DeAndre Love. Ball in the right corner. They're trying to go inside if they can, and they can't. Back cut to Peters. Peters into the lane, across the lane, left side, and an easy dunk for Reggie Lyons. He's got six. Makes it 50-46 in favor of the Colonels with 10:05 left to go. They're going to run a double team at C.J. Jones. He just goes right around it. Finds Larry Owens. He'll get it back to Jones. 9:55 left. Demons down four. 50-46. Jones works with the right hand, right corner. Brandon Hutton drives there, and he is bumped out of bounds. The blocking foul on Kimani Jackson will be his fourth. So Jackson will check out. Tavon Sadler comes back in. Jackson picks up his fourth personal. Czar Perry will check in for C.J. Jones, and that'll be the first break that C.J. Jones has had in this game. Jones has played the entire game until now. So a full 30, almost 31 minutes of action for C.J. Jones. Czar Perry lobs it into DeAndre Love, left wing long. He'll pull it all the way back out. Hands to Czar Perry with 15 to shoot. Perry guarded by Sadler. Steps back on the dribble, now works to the left side, goes right past him. Perry flies to the right hand, good! Czar Perry's got six. 50 to 48, and the Demons get a turnover. Perry can't hit the bucket, however. Back the other way, Roddy Peters, full head of steam right down the lane, and he's fouled from behind. Not a bad foul by Larry Owens, though. Peters was full head of steam, headed to the basket. And so not a bad foul for Owens to pick that one up. That is his second personal. Third for the Demons. They'll inbound from the right baseline. They lob it out to Lyons, the big man. Holding there, now feeds it underneath, right to DeAndre Love. Demons get the turnover. Czar Perry into the front court with it. Demons down two with the basketball. Pulls it out with 9:10 remaining. 50 to 48, Nicholls, cutting at the top. Dribbles all the way to the left wing. Now DeAndre Love, tough catch, but he makes it. Love dribbles all the way to the right wing. Picks up his dribble. Gives to Czar Perry deep with nine to shoot. Perry guarded by Powell. High screen and roll. Flips it back to Ishmael Lane, but he turns it over. Was looking for Lane in the corner. Mike McConaughey telling his guys on that set, you got to go set a pick. So the Demons turn it over for the 14th time in this ballgame. Five in the first half, now nine in the second half. Both teams with 14 turnovers. Ball on the right wing, Kevin Johnson. Works against Czar Perry with the left hand. Skips it into the corner. Three on the way from there from Powell is no good. Perry clears the rebound. Perry flies into the front court with it. Works with the right hand dribble. Takes it down the lane. Scoop with the right hand. No good. Follow is good. DeAndre Love. And Mike McConaughey takes the timeout after the Demons have tied it up by at 50 apiece. DeAndre Love with a second putback. And the Demons have tied it back up at 50 with 8:35 left to go. Northwestern State and Nicholls, 50 apiece. We'll take a full break, come back with more after this. You're listening to the Demon Sports Network.
Also a cage challenge. So if the Demons score 55 points, you win. Just take your game ticket or shooting coupon to the local Raisin Cane's on Kaiser Avenue. By the close of business tomorrow, buy any box combo and get a second absolutely free. It's the cage challenge from Raisin Cane's.
This Demon Sports Network broadcast is brought to you by State Farm agents Buddy Wood, Jim Pledger, Glenn Talbert, Mike Murphy, and Linda Luck. Northwestern State and Nicholls tied at 50 apiece. The Demons have done a fantastic job tonight. Not folding at all, staying right with the Colonels. They've led by as much as seven. They've trailed by as many as four. Currently out-rebounding Nicholls 28-25, thanks in large part to DeAndre Love's two offensive rebounds, both of those putbacks for scores. He's got 7 points in this one. Roddy Peters, pass Hutton, flips it in the left corner. Powell fires another three. It's good. Javon Powell's got 13. He's averages just over two made threes a ball game. But so far in this one, he's knocked down a couple. Czar Perry on the right wing. Down by three. Perry works to the top with 15 to shoot. Works with the left hand, goes right past the defender, off glass and good. Czar Perry's got eight. 53-52. Northwestern State down a point with 7:52 left to go in the ball game. Perry has that ability. Peters drives just inside the free throw line. It's good. Roddy Peters has 18. 55-52. Kazar Perry in the backcourt, guarded by Javon Powell. He'll bring it into the front court. Works all the way to the right wing. Trying to get Larry Owens underneath. Owens posting up big. Hutton, he'll drive the right side into traffic. Pull it all the way back out to the corner. Lob inside to Owens. Owens turns to face. Strip from behind. The lob ahead. It's knocked off of Brandon Hutton's head, but picked up by the Colonels. Up the left side into the corner, Peters. He'll drive from there. That shot is up and no good. Rebound up high. Offensive rebound putback is good. Tavon Sadler. He's got 12, and the Colonels lead by 5. It's their largest lead of the ballgame, 57-52. Perry into the front court, has it stripped into the back court. He gets it back, brings it into the front court again, goes behind the back, takes it down the lane, flips it to Larry Owens. Owens to the reverse, and good. Larry Owens has 10. 57-54, quickly back the other way, and the Demons knock it away from the Colonels. Wait, they want a correction on that one. Crowd, I didn't see it. I was looking down. Demon fans certainly thought that that was off of Nicholls and should belong to the Demons, but we're not going to have an overrule, it doesn't appear. 6:45 left. Northwestern State down 3. 57-54. We'll take a break. Come back with more after this on the Demon Sports Network.
NSU basketball, a dream team.
Agents Tommy Chester, Trey Murray, Mickey Walker, and Julie Henderson. Northwestern State down by 3. The Demons on defense. 57-54 Colonels. Colonels trying to clinch at least a share of the Southland Conference Championship with a win tonight. Demons trying to deny them that opportunity here on the Demons' home floor. Out long, Roddy Peters will be guarded by Cameron Lazar. Peters works with the left hand, takes it all the way down, has it stripped by Lazar, flips it ahead to Malik Matuire. Matuire takes it down the left side, lays it up and in! Cameron Lazar starting that one, and the Demons have cut the lead to 1 at 57-56. That's why Mike McConathy has started Cameron Lazar the last 4 games. Tavon Sadler against Matuire into the corner. Lafayette Rutledge shot is blocked, but the foul is going to be called on Zar Perry. Perry flying out to stop Rutledge's 3-point attempt. And instead will give Lafayette Rutledge 3 free throws. Rutledge, a great 3-point shooter, just a 71% free throw shooter. You'd figure as good a 3-point shooter as he is, he'd be a little bit better, like 80% from the line. First one on the way is good. Lafayette Rutledge, that is his first point of the ballgame. Makes it 58-56 Colonels with 6:12 left to go. Second free throw is good. Rutledge makes 2 of his 3 so far. Pushes the lead back to 3 at 59-56 with 6:12 remaining. Demons have played a fabulous game tonight. And Rutledge misses the last one. Rebound tipped around. Will finally be on the floor, and it'll go out of bounds off the Demons. And Malik Matuire got rolled up on pretty awkwardly. He's a little bit slow to get up. He kind of holding his jaw as the Demons scrap for that rebound, but unfortunately it was knocked out of bounds by Lazar and Malik Matuire. And so now the Demons, Ishmael Lane and Cameron Lazar, will get in there and wipe the sweat up from where Matuire and Lazar went spilling onto the floor. By the way, Northwestern State has taken a 2-1 lead in baseball at J.C. Love Field in Ruston. Demons getting a 1-run top of the 7th. They lob it out long. Demons now lead 2-1 in baseball. Sadler against Matuire, spins inside, loses it. Stripped away by Matuire, picked up by Lazar, and we're going to have a stoppage of play Oh, and Tavon Sadler is really hurt. He is screaming down on the floor. So we are definitely going to see. That's a bad injury for Tavon Sadler as he is screaming down on the floor under his own basket. Went into traffic and came down awkwardly on that right leg. And the senior from Aberdeen, Maryland, 12 points so far in this one, but he is the second leading scorer for Nicholls this season, averaging nearly 16 a game, and Tavon Sadler is down and in a lot of pain. We will take a break. They've got his right leg extended here, but it looks like it's definitely something with his knee. We'll take a full break, full timeout. We'll come back. Northwestern State down 56 with the basketball when we return, but a bad injury to Tavon Sadler. You're listening to the Demon Sports Network.
The Nicholls Parish Sheriff's Office.
Tavon Sadler had driven in and had it stripped by Malik Matuire, came down awkwardly and is up off the floor and being helped off the floor by the training staff for Nicholls and Northwestern State Facilities Director Mike Doty. So a tough break for Nicholls. That is one of their top players. Second leading scorer, Tavon Sadler, who had 12 in this ballgame. Demons will bring it in for Zar Perry. Will go right by everyone. He'll take it up the right side. Split with the right hand. Good. Zar Perry just took it coast to coast. And it's 59-58. Nicholls with the one-point lead. Roddy Peters against Cameron Lazar. Stripped again by Lazar. Picked up by C.J. Jones. Cameron Lazar playing amazing defense. 5.5 left. Demons down one with the basketball. 1-4 high set. C.J. Jones on the dribble right wing. Inside to Ishmael Lane. Lane turns, spins right baseline. Loses his goggles. Gets his own rebound. Puts it back up. No good. Rebound is knocked out long. It'll go out of bounds off of Nicholls. It'll belong to the Demons with a fresh 30-second clock. Good hustle by the Demons. Good hustle by Ishmael Lane. Thought he was fouled. Didn't get the call. Now he's going to have to tuck his shirt tail in as he worked hard to try to get that bucket on the putback. After Zar Perry just went completely through the Nicholls press and laid it up, he's got 10 points now. Three guys in double digits for the Demons. Lane with 11, Perry and Owens with 10. C.J. Jones dribbles to the right wing. Works back to the basket, turns, wants to go to Lane. Now we'll get it to him. Lane turns, steps back, jumper no good. Offensive rebound, and we're going to have an over-the-back foul on Malik Matuire. The fans really not liking that call. Matuire picks up his third. And Mike McConathy incensed with our lead official, Brent Moe, after that over-the-back call. So Peters, who's been stripped twice in a row by Cameron Lazar, works off the screen down the left side, flips it to a cutter. No one in particular. It goes all the way back long, and Zar Perry comes away with it. Perry into the front court, splits defenders. Righty scoop is good! Zar Perry gives the Demons back the lead, 60-59 with 4:35 left to go. Richie Riley screaming for a timeout. The crowd is on its feet. Northwestern State leads 60-59 with 4:31 left to go. Take a 30-second break, 30-second, and back with more after this on the Demon Sports Network. Left to go in this one. Northwestern State leads 60-59. Czar Perry, 10 in the second half, 12 for the ball game, and the Demons have retaken a one-point lead, and it's been the defense of Cameron Lazar that's doing it. Lazar against Peters. He drives the right side. Foul is going to be called. Shot will not fall off the backboard. Foul will be called on Lazar. That'll be his third personal. But Cameron Lazar stripped Roddy Peters on two consecutive possessions. Lazar has four steals in this ballgame. Lazar also picked up his first points of the season in this one in the first half. Peters, first one is good. He ties us back up at 60 with 4:24 remaining. Roddy Peters has 19 in this one. Cameron Lazar playing amazing defense on Roddy Peters. Peters at 6'4", Lazar at 5'11". Peters makes both free throws. He's got 20. Lead is back to one for Nicholls. 61-60 with 4:17 remaining. Jones into the front court, long on the right side. Now he'll pull it all the way back out. No one getting open for him with 14 to shoot. Jones will take it himself, pull it back, flip it up top to Perry. Perry with eight. Perry stops just inside the three-point line. Good! Czar Perry's got 14! And the Demons back on top, 62-61 with 3:50 left to go. Peters again cleared out against Lazar, drives in. Ball is good, and he's fouled. Cameron Lazar, actually they're going to call the foul on Malik Matuire, and that is Matuire's fourth. So it makes it a 63-62 lead. Roddy Peters has 22. And we've got our final media timeout. 3:47 left. Demons down a point. 63-62. You're listening to the Demon Sports Network. Other scores, Central Arkansas leads Sam Houston 57-53. That's midway second half. Southeastern leads UNO 38-31 at halftime. HBU leading Incarnate Word 51-45. Corpus leads McNeese at halftime 32-31. SFA all over Abilene Christian 47-21. Here are the Demons down 63-62. The and one free throw is good for Roddy Peters. He's got 23. Makes it 64-62 in favor of the Colonels with 3:43 remaining. C.J. Jones will bring it into the front court, long on the right side. Dribbles with the left hand, spins back around. Gives it to Cameron Lazar, long right side. Up top to Ishmael Lane, looking inside. Now back right wing to Jones. Jones will dribble with the left hand, take it into the lane into traffic. Shot is blocked, but the foul is called. And C.J. Jones will shoot two to try to tie us up. Foul called on Kimani Jackson, and that's the big fella's fifth. So Kimani Jackson, one of the big, 6'7", 225, the transfer from Colorado State. He will leave. He will be replaced by Reggie Lyons. And now, C.J. Jones, the freshman point guard, 7 points in the first half, none so far here in the second half. Goes to the line to try to tie us up with 3:24 remaining. First free throw is good. Jones has eight. By the way, Jones is Wasserman's squad, coached by his dad, Casey, is in the semifinals, or the third round, I should say, of the Louisiana High School playoffs. As Jones makes one of two. It's a one-point lead with 3:20 left to go for Nicholls. Another clear out for Roddy Peters against Cameron Lazar. Peters works with the right hand, takes it in, strip, knocked away. He was trying to throw it in the corner, and Lazar Perry knocked that one out of bounds. 18 to shoot, 3:12 left. Cam Lazar has played incredible defense against Roddy Peters. Peters crosses over, works down the right side. Shot is up, no good, but he's fouled. Foul is called on Ishmael Lane. That'll be his first. And the entire Nicholls offense for about the last 3 minutes or so has been clear out for Roddy Peters. He's got 23, 15 in the first half, 8 in the second half. By the way, in Ruston, it's a 2-2 ball game. Demons scored one in the seventh. So did Louisiana Tech, 2-2. That one. Peters now has 24. He makes the first free throw. Second one on the way is also good. Peters has 25. 3-point lead for the Colonels, 66-63. Demons with the basketball with 3:05 remaining. Trying to keep Nicholls from clinching at least a share of the Southland Championship here in Natchitoches. Czar Perry feeds to Ishmael Lane right wing. Perry will drive, Lane will drive right side. He lost it out of bounds. Demons wanted a push, didn't get it. Lane just turns it over. That is the Demons' 11th turnover of the second half. They had just five at halftime. And once again, it's going to be a clear out for Roddy Peters against Cameron Lazar. 2:45 remaining. Demons down three. Peters drives with the right hand, takes it down the right side, lost it. Ishmael Lane comes out with it. Bizarre Perry. Perry up the left side, puts it up, no good. Follow slam! Ishmael Lane! He's got 13, and the Demons have cut the lead to one at 66-65 with 2:27 left to go in this one. Down the right side, Peters across the lane. Back to the basket. Shot is no good. Jump ball! Possession will go back to the Demons. Malik McTwire drew the jump ball. Demons down a point with the basketball with 2:16 remaining. Ishmael Lane with his first points of the second half came on a follow slam of a miss by Czar Perry. Perry, though, has been the story in the second half with 12 of his 14 points. Into the front court, C.J. Jones running the point. Right wing to Ishmael Lane for three! Yes! Demons lead by two, 68-66. With a minute 54 left to go. Another clear out screen roll this time for Peters on the left wing against Lazar. Crossover into the lane. Shot is up and good off glass for Peters, and Richie Riley takes a timeout as it's tied back up at 68 with a minute 43 left. What a battle by the Demons against the first place Nicholls Colonels. A minute 43 left, 30-second break, 30 seconds, and back with a tie ball game on the Demons Sports Network. Left to go in what has been a beautiful ball game here in Prather Coliseum in Natchitoches. The Demons not wanting to let Nicholls celebrate a conference championship on their home floor. Demons and Colonels tied at 68 apiece. Demons with the basketball after Roddy Peters had a drive and lay-in. C.J. Jones into the front court with a minute 35 remaining. Jones right wing to Lane. Just knocked down a three. Lane works with the left hand. Long two on the way is an air ball and out of bounds. Lane thought it was tipped and blocked. No call. So we go the other way. Now maybe not the shot you want at that point in the shot clock. But Ishmael Lane has been the straw that stirs the drink for the Demons all season long. Has 16 points in this one along with four rebounds. Peters, top of the key. Three on the way from the top is no good. Rebound to the left side, missed by Powell. He got hit on the face as I believe it was C.J. Jones was flying by. Mike McConathy is going to want to call a timeout here. C.J. Jones will get the timeout with a minute three left. Richie Riley has a point. It was very clear that Powell got hit on the head as he was getting ready to shoot. Mike McConathy takes the timeout. It's a full break. We're tied at 68 with a minute three left. Demons with the basketball when we return on the Demons Sports Network. Left to go. Demons and Colonels tied at 68. Demons with the basketball. Malik Matuire will inbound right by the Demon bench. For NSU, this has got to go to Ishmael Lane or Czar Perry. The freshman or the leader for the Demons, the junior, Ishmael Lane. Czar Perry into the front court with 15 to shoot. Dribbling out long. He's going to work with the left hand, back behind the back to the right hand. Gets his own shot back, throws it in the corner for Jones. Jones penetrates, pulls up, short. Rebound Nicholls. 45 seconds left to go. Jones had time. I think he rushed the shot just a little bit. And now Roddy Peters against Cameron Lazar on the clear out. Shot clock will go under 19-18. Peters dribbling out near half court. Crowd gets on its feet. 30 seconds left. Peters, high screen and roll. Goes away from it. Down the right side. Shot is up off glass and good for Peters. Roddy Peters with 29 and the Demons trail by two, 70-68. Shot clock is off. Czar Perry pulls it back. Drives with the left hand to the right hand. Ishmael Lane with 12. Lane wants to get it back to Perry. Throws it away. It's into the front court, and that's going to be a foul on the Demon C.J. Jones. And in the end, a turnover undoes the Demons. Richie Riley wanting a flagrant foul. This would be a tough position to call a flagrant on with 8 seconds left. As Lane was looking for Perry, Perry cut to his left and then back to his right. And they're going to call that a common foul. So 1-1 will be the call. C.J. Jones picks up his second personal. And so Roddy Peters, it wasn't Peters that was grabbed. That's the wrong shooter. That's the wrong shooter. That's the wrong shooter. It wasn't Peters who was grabbed. First into the 1-1 is good. 3-point lead for the Colonels, 71-68 with 8 seconds remaining. So Roddy Peters, by the way, that's the wrong shooter. So a timeout taken by the Demons, 8 seconds left to go. Northwestern State down three. We'll take a 30-second break. It's the wrong shooter. Take a break, come back with more after this on the Demons Sports Network. We'll be right back. seconds left. It's been all Roddy Peters in the second half for the Colonels. He's got 30 points for Roddy Peters, 15 in each half. Demons trail by three, 71-68, with 8.1 seconds remaining. Jacob Guest is in as a three-point specialist. Peters makes both free throws. He's got 31. Demons are going to have to get up a three quickly. Czar Perry into the front court, drives it all the way down, lays it up with the left hand, good, with 2.7 seconds remaining. Demons will foul with 1.5 seconds remaining. So they cut the lead to 72-70. Basically, it's this. And Stephen Kim's going to get some action here. The Demon trainer will step onto the floor. Stephen Kim, 5'9", 165, the senior from Salem, Oregon, out of Sprague High School and the University, or Baylor University. So Peters will go to the line to shoot the one and one. It's two fouls. If he hits both, the game's over. If he hits just one, the Demons have a chance. If he misses them, so two shots. Demons trying to get Stephen Kim into the ballgame. He can't come in until after the first free throw since it's now two shots. So C.J. Jones will just stand in the court of play down by the Demon bench. So Roddy Peters goes to the line. Two free throws, and that will likely clinch a share of the conference championship. He misses the first. It'll be no more than a three-point deficit for the Demons as Stephen Kim checks into the ballgame. The Demon athletic trainer gets in. Wouldn't it be amazing to see him hit a three to tie this thing up? 1.5 seconds. One of two free throws goes. Jacob Guest is going to throw it long. That one is tipped and out of bounds. It'll belong to the Demons with 3/10 of a second remaining. So Roddy Peters made one of two. He's got 32. The lead is three, 73-70. The officials may have to go back and check the clock here to make sure that an extra 10th of a second didn't fall off the clock. Richie Riley not pleased as he talks to Henry Howard and Brent Moe. And he is vociferous. And now we get some activity near the Demon bench as the Nicholls team was all in the Demon huddle. And now this has gotten wild as the Colonels were all in the bench of the Demons. That could have been a technical situation, but cooler heads prevailed among the officiating crew. They're going to put 1 second on the clock. 1 second. That's enough to catch and shoot for the Demons with 1 second. A three will tie it and send us to overtime. Well, it couldn't be easy for the Colonels, and the Demons are not making it easy. And Brent Moe and Richie Riley, a long conversation in front of us. And now with 1 second left, the Demons will be looking for a three to try to tie it. They can catch and shoot. Three to tie and send it to overtime. Jacob Guest will trigger the inbound. Henry Howard tells the Nicholls bench to sit down on the far side. Jacob Guest will trigger it. Demons run guys through. They get it to Czar Perry. Turns, fires for three. No! And the Colonels have won their Southland Conference championship. And all the way to the bench, Richie Riley in the ear of Henry Howard. Wow. That'll look classy finish to that one.